Okay, I'd like to go ahead and call to order the regular meeting of the Gainesville City Commission for March 19, 2015. All right, so now we'll move into citizen comment. With that said, Mr. Konish, you're recognized.
Mr. Mayor, Jim Konish. I really appreciate Todd Chase's speaking out piece in the Gainesville Sun today. He had it right on the head, and if anyone would like to, if you could zoom in on this a little bit, if anyone would like to see how Representative Perry...
Can someone zoom in on that for the speaker?
If you would like to see how Representative Perry was treated at the last meeting on governance by the Bouchers and other members of the DEC mob, you need to look at this, and you'll learn a lot about what's wrong with the politics in our community. Commissioner Chase hit the nail right on the head today. I thank him for that. If anyone would like to see Craig Carter in action up in Tallahassee trying to kill Perrysville, you need to look at this internet site. I was told not to drive up there, that it was going to pass 10-2. It actually passed 13-0 in a bipartisan vote. I think Commissioner Carter wasted his gas. I had a little piece in the Gainesville Sun about sacred cows, and in case anyone doesn't know what I'm talking about, I want to give you an example of a sacred cow that needs to be slaughtered. Here's Faith Presbyterian Church. And this church has a special deal that very few people know about that comes from a little one-page contract that no one knows about because it's not mentioned in the ordinances, and there's some handwriting here which sweetened the pot a little bit. But basically, I want to compare this to a Christian church that's not in the, that doesn't have the inside information. I deleted the name of that church. Now I want to show you something. Faith Presbyterian is right here. These are all the same point in time, same rates. 3,500, 754, 0.13 dropping out the fuel. This church that doesn't have the honeypot agreement, it's paying three times as much for half a consumption. Now, are these the conservation rates everyone's saying Perrysville threatened, or is this just a sacred cow that needs to be slaughtered? I also want to compare what a residential rate of 2,500 would be right here. It would be lower. So it's these kind of sacred cows that must be eliminated. When Perrysville addresses preferences, this is what we're talking about. Not tearing. This is outrageous. Anybody that can sign a piece of paper and purchase electricity for one-third the price of somebody that doesn't know about this piece of paper is actually doing a disservice to all the ratepayers. And a body that would allow something so outrageous and incidentally illegal to take on needs to resign. Thank you.
I'd like to address to the point.
Commissioner Carter, you're recognized.
Just as it's no secret, Faith Presbyterian Church is the church that I'm the elder at. That deal that you're discussing was made 6 years ago. And the reason that deal is in effect, because we use our power on the weekends, we don't use heavy demand power during the week. We did at one point on a Wednesday peak our power. GRU came out and did an assessment. So if that other church is using peak power during the week, that would be the biggest reason. And this has nothing to do with me being an elected official. That's a deal I made as a deacon at that church.
That's why I didn't bring it up, sir. But, you know,
there are 800 churches.
Commissioner Carter is recognized.
But I just do appreciate the fact that you used my church's name, but you blacked out the other. So when you're accusing everybody of being underhanded and shaded, please just say what you mean, sir.
I will write every church in town and let them know the deal that your church enjoys so they can get on board with it. Thank you.
And I said it in public in front of Kathy B. in our RUC meeting when this guy was chairing that at my church they came out, they did an assessment, and it's all on tape. And I said they were very helpful. I encourage everybody to do it.
I'm going to do assessment. I'm going to do my own outreach.
That's wonderful, sir.
All right. That's good.
Can I get that in my house?
So, appreciate it. Boy, this is a lively public comment period. Anyone else want to come talk to us about anything not on the agenda? I mean, we'll take it all up. Israeli elections. Go for it.
Okay. I just wanted to return to what the first gentleman brought up about the agreement that apparently Faith Presbyterian Church has with the city or GRU. Could this type of agreement also be made available to Grace Marketplace?
All right. Well, so I think probably at some point, I don't know the nature of any particular arrangement. I know over the years, you know, when you look at large user, there you go, Kathy hit her button. Yeah. Let's let Ms. V, our interim general manager. So
Mr. Mayor, yes. So Commissioner Carter actually did a very good job describing this demand, this rate. It's churches have usage one time a week, usually. And so because of that, they're not a very good customer to serve. Their load is very intermittent. And so that's why we provide that rate for churches. Grace is a much different kettle of fish, if you will. Their demand is every day, very, very similar to what our other customers have. And so under state law, we have to provide rates to those customers that are similarly situated. So I think the answer is no.
Yeah. Yeah, I think what we heard the first speaker is an attempt to suggest that there was a sort of a favored deal going on because someone's a commissioner, and that is not the case at all. And
no, I didn't assume that.
Right. No, I didn't say you did. I'm saying you're right. So, but that's a good, you know, question to ask, and I know that the question of the utility rates at Grace have been brought to this attention because
they're outrageous.
Well, they're outrageous for everyone, but they are outrageous for Grace too. So we're working on it.
Okay.
Thank you. Any other members of the public wish to speak to us at this time? Okay. With that said, we will close the public comment period.